Without further ado, let's start up with some music. I want to introduce someone whose music is new to me. He lives in the region with us here, and I hear that he is very well known for his interpretations of Celtic music, but I can also tell you that from soundcheck, he can really rip it up with some blues. Please welcome David Surette.
Thanks, folks, for coming. It's an honor to start things off here. I'm very happy to be in such impressive and enjoyable company. One of the themes of the evening seems to be a bit of a tribute, so I'm going to start with a tribute tune of mine, which was actually written for the great English guitar player John Renborn. I lived in a musical household my senior year of college, which is when I first got acquainted with Michael. And we had the, Sir John Allotta of record in heavy rotation in our household, as I'm sure some of you did at various times. And I stole so many licks off the album, I decided I should pay it back a little bit with an homage, so I called it Allotta of Sir John. Thank you. mentioned the musical household, which was how I first met Michael, which was through our mutual friend Eric Goodenough. Just barely good enough, we used to call him. And so there was a lot of mystique around Mike at the beginning, you know, because he was this mysterious luthier over in the woods. It was Richmond at that point, and he was, you know, a great guitar maker, and also reputed to be a great acoustic blues guitar player. So, you know, we'd hear stories. Yeah, Mike, he's a great acoustic blues guitar player. That's so cool. Yeah, but he won't play for you. That's even cooler! So we'd go visit Mike and we'd listen to him not play guitar. Those were good times. But he had a great record collection, you know, back in the day when you had vinyl. And so we'd go and we'd raid the record collection. And remember back then, you'd tape people's record collection. So, you know, we did that. We made the Maxell 90-minute tapes of Gary Davis, Mississippi John Hurt, and all that good stuff. So got some intro to the country blues that way. So this is a tune I actually dedicated to Michael and the spirit of the old country blues stuff. It's called Frog's Legs. Differently from standard tuning. I know a lot of you are familiar with that, but some of you may never have encountered that idea before, that there are different ways to tune the guitar depending on what you're trying to do or what you're trying to discover. And this is a tuning called Dadgad, creatively named because the strings are D-A-D-G-A-D. It's gotten used a lot for Celtic music, so this is a tune. It's an arrangement of mine of a few traditional dance tunes from Brittany. The first tune is called, it's a dance tune called a dérobé. And then there's a Breton gavotte. Thank you. original tune. My wife, Susie Burke, is also a fine musician, singer, guitar player. Another Froggy Bottom player. So we were recording a Christmas album a couple years ago, and we have a great little studio just in our town, just down the road, a nice old converted post and beam barn. Very sympathetic engineer, Chris Magruder. And he's the kind of engineer that, you know, if you say, well, we're just going to run through this number before we tape it, he'll say, oh, why don't you just run through it with the tape roller? You know, so kind of guy you want to have in the studio, around in the studio, because these days there is no tape that actually rolls in most studios. So, you know, tape is cheap, time is not, but let it roll while you're in there. So we were sort of between takes, and I started noodling around, and he came on the talk box about 2 minutes and 14 seconds later and said, what was that? And I said, oh, I don't know, just kind of noodling around. He said, well, I got it. So, take it home on a CD, and you think, oh, gee, that's kind of an interesting idea. So it grew out of that little thing that he called the Dadgad Noodle. I decided to call it Sky Boys, because Chris's studio is called Thundering Sky. And it also has a little tip of the cap to English guitar player Davy Graham, who was an early adapter and explorer of the Dadgad realm. He was kind of the English Icarus of the late 60s and early 70s. Flew a little too high, a little too close to the sun, a little too often. But some very, very, very inspirational guitar playing from that era. So this is Sky Boys.